it's not one of them houses that, oh, you need to, by invitation only, you just sort of walk in.
Yours and Sophie's friends always popping by. The house was always somebody in there, apart from me, of course.
I liked the flat. I liked living in the flat. I was always happy in the flat.
My friend Tim would never leave. He's only lived up the road, but he was always there.
I slept in your mum's room on a mattress on the floor.
One day I was working and I came home because it was going to be a long shift, and I came home for a little sleep in the middle of the day, and she was asleep on the chair next to the bed.
Yeah, Tim used to like smelling your makeup brushes and your clothes.
Mum gave me a sleeping pill.
So I thought, I won't disturb her, because she was deaf. Obviously that was her name, Deafy.
It's like cut in his hand. I was caught him. He was still trying to sniff at your lucky interview shirt.
2 minutes after I took the sleeping pill, your mum went off to sleep.
Then Sophie came in to wake me up, and I said to her, blimey, I said, Deafy's having a good sleep. I said, she's in the same position.
We used to hang up, we used to sort of sit underneath it like that. Okay.
And I was wide awake all night.
When I went to touch her, she was like an ironing board. She was solid.
Oh yeah, rubber gloves on his feet. I used to put his socks on and then put the latex gloves on top of his feet and walk around the house. He used to like doing that.
And I had to go back to work.
And then he went and bought a box of rubber gloves from Chris and Sons, you know, the beauticians.
And Sophie screamed because she was... Well, obviously, the cat was just curled up asleep, but her tongue was sticking out and it was